What's up, guys, and welcome back to Let's Play Minecraft for the PlayStation 4. In the last episode, we found this abandoned mineshaft, and we have found cool stuff left and right, and we're preparing for more adventures by knocking down this iron and hopefully, you know, getting some ready for some iron weapons soon, because we are actually, as we speak, running out of our rock pick here. So definitely we need to look into getting some nice iron weapons. We do have the resources for it. We have everything available to us. Now all we have to do is listen to this weird music and make the working bench. So let's do this now. Let's figure this out. So let's, I know I've played the game before. Come on. What is with this? I'm gonna have to disable tooltips soon because this is getting ridiculous. But I wanna do that and also make a few sticks, whatever we can manage. And then we're going to go over here, put this down, or let's do a bit of this. I have my food ready for me. I also have more to cook if I need it. We are on a very organized and prepared adventure. I love it. It's cool. It feels awesome. So now we need to place this down, use it to, where is my cobblestone to make more of this? There we go, and place this down. And we're really rolling with the mojo here. Let's put the iron in and start cooking up some of this. And while that's doing its thing, why don't we adventure around a bit more? We're losing our first bits of hunger, but not into an absolute necessity at this point. I'm gonna just look around. There's a lot of twists and turns in places like this, so we need to make sure to pay attention to where we are at all times to make sure we don't get lost. There was this chest that we bumped into, but we have yet to open it, so guess what we're gonna do right now. We're going to put a torch down. Of course, our safety is so important, so let's put the torches down. Let's also make sure we have some food in our inventory to be ready for just in case we do get attacked and we need some food to eat. But, let's, check out what's in here. Whoa! I'm being shot at! What? Oh, boy, you wanna tussle? You wanna tussle? Okay, I'm gonna do this little hoop. Ha ha ha! Oh, man! Get him, get him, get him! Get him, get him! Oh, man! Ah! Ooh, ooh, lucky I had that second sword now, aren't I? There we go. Take a look at that. We just took him out! What a punk. He thought he could manage taking us out. He doesn't even know what he got himself into. You can't just tussle with the zebra and expect to come out nice and clean. Now you're gonna get some battle scars, and luckily for us, he couldn't handle many scars, but let's take a look at this. What do we got in here? We got 9 lapis lazuli, 4 melon seeds, 2 gold ingots, and some bread. This is my first time having any of these three items right here. Gold ingot, melon seed, lapis lazuli. Actually, we haven't had any of these items. We haven't had any bread. That's more food for us, by the way, if we need to continue surviving. We have more bones to hopefully convince that dog pal back at home to come. Wow, so much stuff, so much awesome progress going on right now. I want to pick this guy up. Of course, like I said, we need to start getting some of this as well, because this will be very, very helpful to us. This, what's it called? This railroad, because we want to get the railroad achievement soon by, getting a really large collection. So I hear more skeletons. We gotta be very, very careful, because we're starting to get in a danger zone where there's enemies all over the place waiting to tear our faces off, and we don't want that. Of course, we want to stay nice and protected with our face. So I'm loving this adventure. This has been fantastically awesome. Now, am I going the correct direction? I might be, I might not be. I think I want to actually go down here. Yeah, there we go. I can't get lost in my own designed mineshaft here. You know, it's like at this point, I'm the one figuring it all out. I gotta be able to keep track. There we go. So I definitely want to knock this stuff back down so that I can take it with me. Don't want to leave this stuff behind, because right now it is very essential and very, very important. But we are doing amazing. I am actually very, very happy with our results at the moment. Let's put the chicken away, let's place this down, and let's make us some iron stuff. So our iron pickaxe, and then we're also going to make an iron sword, because, you know, why not? I love this music. Really starting to kick in. It's like we're ready to kick some butt, aren't we? All right, then let's place this away. Get the sword in here. Not the leather, but the sword. We also have plenty of food. I feel safe. I've never felt so safe playing this game. Okay, then we're going to go over and get the last of this coal to sort of use up the rest of this pickaxe. There we go. I didn't actually use up the rest of the pickaxe, but we made some progress. Now, there's so many ways to go in this, in a mineshaft like this, that I'm not going to trouble myself with trying to go in each and every direction. I'm just going to choose a few directions and go that way and try to enjoy myself for the ride when it comes to this, so it can be quite scary, as there could be monsters showing up in any direction. Let's check our map really quick, and where does it say we are? It says we're way off on the map, so yeah. I hear a spider though. Well, you have to be careful. It's very hard to hear over the music for one thing. So that's something I probably have to change is the audio levels to make sure we can actually hear the monsters. Oh man. Oh boy, okay. We hear spiders galore. There is some type of spider threshold somewhere. All right, let's start placing some stuff down. It looks like I'm good to come over here. Place another one down. At any point, we could run into like a stronghold for monsters. This is insane though. What do we got here? We have 4 pumpkin seeds, 3 pumpkin seeds, 4 pumpkin seeds, 3 iron, and 4 redstone. We're getting items galore here, guys. This is insane. Let's, no. Let's get this as well. There are enemies right over my head. There's some, oh man. This is dangerous as well. At any point, an enemy could try to hop on my head, and that could be the end of me. It's very dangerous. We're not in a safe spot here, but that's what makes it an adventure. Oh my gosh, I'm enjoying myself though. I'm scared, like I'm horrified right now. But at the same time, I'm so excited. This is exactly what I was looking for. It was exactly the adventure, the trek, the journey I wanted to find. Okay, let's get this. I'm gonna use this, and hopefully this will be the last of my rock pickaxe so we can just start focusing on the iron. Out with the old and with the new, you know, the old, good old zing. Made by Shrek himself. Okay, let's get this, and then, whoa. Oh, no. Oh, creepy. I'm stuck in this. Get me out of it. Okay. So, we also have some coal up here. I'm really not in the need for coal, and I'm certain that I'll find some more in the future. Okay, let's use our bread here and get our 2 beasts of hunger up, just so that we're in the safe zone. Man, you can hear them skeletons. We can hear enemies waiting for us. I'm really worried, because it sounds like so many enemies. I'm going to knock this pillar down. There are so many. I'm really hoping we don't end up... No, you don't, buddy. If you want to tussle, then let's tussle. You want to fight, then let's fight. But let me get my weapon out first. No! Oh, darn it. That stinks. I backed up into the pillar. That's not any good at all. Okay, then. Let me get some light in this situation very, very quickly. Because I don't want a situation where there is no light. There we go, we got light in here now. We can see clearly now, the rain is gone. Uh-oh. Looks like we got, uh-oh. Enemies waiting for us down there. I'm not going down there. I just ain't. I don't really want to hop into danger like that. I'm gonna plug the hole up. Just like this. Uh-oh. Didn't want to throw my bread. Did I throw it down the hole? Fine then, have some bread, you cretins. I don't need it. Okay then, we haven't gone down this way. So let's try to do so. And I feel like we are going to end off the adventure soon. Ooh, but not until we find even more goodies. We are finding so much awesome stuff. We got 9 redstone, a collective of 13 coal, and another piece of bread. We made our bread back, so there we go. And then we can take this with us. We found so much awesome stuff here. I feel like the next thing we should do is, of course, get this minecart. This, how much do we have at this point? 42. I'd like to have a full stack, but we'll see how much this will give us. Come on. Give me all this. Give me all this. And this music is fantastic. Alright then. Let's get over and get this stuff too. I am enjoying myself though. I'm thoroughly enjoying our little adventures here. We could go further down, but the risk is high. So I think we should use this little as a gateway to the way out, to victory, to ascension. Because one thing, we hopped down the ravine in the last episode to even get up here. So it's gonna be very hard to make our way up normally, so we need to dig our way up. Now, sometimes digging straight up can be just as much of a danger as digging straight down. So we gotta be careful here. We gotta be ready for anything that the game might throw at us, because there could be an enemy on top of the block that we dig up on. So we gotta be prepared. We gotta be ready for what could happen, which could be anything. And I'm pretty scared. I'm starting to shake and quake. But hopefully our iron pickaxe is strong. It's worthy of waiting for us here and, you know, working for us. Ooh, running into some dirt that usually is a clear sign that we're making our way to the top. I'm gonna put another torch down. And I'm happy. I am a happy camper in this situation. The lighting is changing, which means we gotta be reaching the top soon, right? We're not gonna be able to dig up into oblivion, right? What if we dug up into a mountain and this is gonna take like forever? I don't know, it would be ZebraLuck, hashtag ZebraLuck. That's a little meme that we started on our Little Big Planet community night the other night. A whole bunch of unlucky things were happening to me, so we all started tweeting hashtag ZebraLuck. Let's see if my hashtag ZebraLuck will continue on this episode, or will actually improve. You never know. Alright then, Alright, dirt. Oh, we're at the top! And it's daytime. Oh man. Sweet daylight. Sweet, sweet daylight. Don't look directly into the sun. Our eyes aren't ready for it. Alright then, let's take a look at our map. Where are we? This is a scary part, is it won't tell me which way I'm going because of I'm way off the map. Huh, what is that red piece on the map as well? Is that lava? Okay then, now that we have emerged from the abyss, we have to find our way back home, which might be an easier task than it may appear. I do believe that home is this way. I'm gonna follow my zebra senses here and go this way. Looks like we also have some dead bushes here. Is that the case? Look at this stuff. Nasty, dead bushes. It gets us seeds though, so why don't we just destroy it a bit? There we go. Yeah, I have a feeling it's off this way. Yeah, I remember this mountain. I don't know why, but I do. It strikes familiar to me. And there's the sand, okay. We are heading back home, guys. Back on the road again. Back home to my friends. Wait, I live alone. I have no friends. Whoa, it's fire. What's happening over here? I saw some fire. Hopefully everybody's, falling in the water, I can't swim. Help me. Luckily I can swim and I also have my spoon to dig me out. Okay, what's going on here? Lava, what do you know? Cool stuff. So this is lava, guys. Now, of course, I don't want to step in that. I'm going to die if I do, so we're going to be careful. We're going to go around it, avoid it, but it's nice to know it's there. We have it set on our map, so we can always check it out sometime in the future. Uh-oh. Oh, I'm hearing enemies. You know, I really don't want to, mess... Wow. You got like 30 gurgles at once. I wonder... I don't know. It's just... Oh my gosh, why am I hearing so many enemies out here on the ground? There must be a stronghold somewhere here where you can, you know, like where the enemies are all spawned in and I don't know. Okay, so I need to go this way, right? Let's look at our map. Yep, we're heading about the right way. Oh, what am I doing? What am I doing? Okay, pick this stuff up. Now, get this. Where'd it go? Where'd my map go? I feel like I'm staring straight at it, but I'm not. Because it's still over here, what do you know? Okay then, so we basically have a full inventory at this point. Interesting stuff. Got a sheep. Let me kill Mr. Sheep over here. There we go. Sorry, sheep, but I have to. Alright then, let's continue on. And hopefully we can find, you know, some cool stuff. Ooh! It's the wolf. Is this the wolf? Who knows? But there's only one way to really find out. And that's to try our luck with him. We only ran into one skeleton, so... This is all, hey buddy. Here you go, wait. Here you go, he loves me! He did it! I'm going to name you Pooch. And we're going to have a lot of adventures. And we're going to have a good time. And we're going to live happily ever after. Come on, let's go. I'm so happy now. Let's get our map back out. Today is a good day. Today is a genuinely good day for all of Zebrakind. Our dog's gonna follow us and help us on our adventures here. We need to continue in this direction. Now, the cool thing about the dog is that he can sort of just follow us. He will follow us wherever we go. Of course, he might have a hard time making it up hills, but after a while, he'll either learn how to hop up or he'll just teleport to you. Whatever way is easiest for him, I suppose. And whoa. Weird level generation in this world. I love it though. It's so cool, so unique, so much fun. I cannot express how happy I am. I got my own little pooch and he's by my side and we walk around. Cool. What's the... Wow, we're like in a nice like zen forest. I love it. Cow over there. See this guy, I only needed to win him over with just one bone. Well, the other guy I gave like four bones to and he just wouldn't give up. You know, it's... Man, I'm so happy though. I know that somebody did comment on one of the previous episodes that I should, like, when I'm feeding them the bones, that I should look directly at his face, like his mouth, and that, like, I don't know, he or she insinuated that that would increase my chances. I don't know if it actually did or not, but maybe it did. Try it out for yourself. Maybe you'll get the dog more easily. Anyways, we're almost there. Of course, we've been in this location before, if you recall. He's still right behind us. He's always like a slower pace behind us, but he's still there. He's still there. All right, then let's hop up here. And I love this music. This is more classic music. All right, so we're gonna be off this way a bit. We're almost there. We're almost home, guys. This has been an amazingly fun adventure, and there we are, our lovely abode. I do quickly want to knock this guy down. I don't need all of it. Actually, I don't think I have enough room right now. Yes, okay, our main goal should be getting back inside. Hello, sheep. There we go. Okay, yeah, our goal should definitely be to get back inside and sort of relax for a moment. Chillax for a moment. Let's get Pooch in here. Come on, Pooch. Here, boy. Pooch, come in. Pooch? Pooch, where'd you go? I don't know. He'll find his way in, I'm sure. But anyways, we can go in here and put a lot of this stuff in. Of course, not many of this we need immediately. So a lot of it we can stow away in here. I will get the iron, though. There we go. Actually, I'm probably gonna need a few of these as well. All right then, wow, we have tons of stuff now. I definitely think we benefited from that. So let's put some of it away. Oh, I just put this back in, then I put it away again. And I will need the white wool. We only have 3 pieces of it, not a big deal. But of course, some. All right then, here we go. Where's Pooch? Pooch, where are you, buddy? Come in. Welcome to your new home, buddy. Come on. Do I push you in? Maybe we can just push him in. There we go, come on, get in. There we go. And now sit. There we go, hey, I'm so happy. Now we do actually need the light in this corner. There we go. What happened to you? You're like darker now. I guess it's just a lighting glitch, right? The dog that just quickly changes pitches. Okay, I know somebody did also comment that you can change the color of their little, what's it called? Collars, and that's cool. I would like to change it to green. And before we do that though, I'm running out of hunger. Let me eat some pork chop. There we go. I want to try this out. Now we just learned in the last episode that we can turn cactus into green dye. Let's see how. It would be very helpful to know. Would it be somewhere in here? What is this? It's lime dye. No, I don't have the ingredients for that. There's a lot of dyes, oh my lord. Come on, why is it that green was there? Like, it's here on the screen, like you use green and white to make lime dye, but how do you make green dye? I don't know, it's not showing. This is weird stuff, maybe I went over. I'm gonna quickly go through again. No, it's not here. Huh. How do I make green dye? Oh, it's dark yet. Okay, let's hit the hay. Can you guys help me out with that? How do you make green dye? It would be very helpful to know. I would like to give him a green collar. Thank you to the commenter who told me that you can change this collar like that. That's very cool. The collar color. I don't know why, but that's like a fun little tongue twister. Collar. Anyways, let's do that. And then finally, let's go back in here and let's actually make some, where is it? Red wool. That's what we'll need soon. Where would that be? It's right here. There we go, and then more carpeting. Here. There we go. Okay, so it's not a ton indeed, but it'll get us somewhere, and that's what's making me happy. We are making some awesome progress so far, but I'd really like to hear you guys' thoughts. What do you guys have been thinking about these most recent episodes? Have you been enjoying watching me play through Minecraft and its adventures provided? You know, I've been having a blast. It's been so much fun, but with that being said, I'd like to thank you guys so much for watching this episode. Like I said, what have you been enjoying most about the series? Can I place it down though still? Is it not gonna let me? No, okay. So that's the one fault of carpet. I will have to replace it with bedrock. But thank you guys so much for watching. If you enjoyed this video, please consider giving it a like and sharing it with your friends and family, because your support really does help. Thank you guys so much for watching, and I'll see you guys later. Bye-bye.